Right, let's do some streaming again for a change. Realized I was muted the entire time. Yeah, I think Twitch actually clumps it. That's the wrong paint to start with. So I'll say all that again. So this guy's now undercoated, and the wing is intentionally left off. Otherwise, we won't be able to paint all this stuff under here. But we're going to start with the lava base. This is the cork that's just had the texture paint put on it, spray painted black. It feels like it's warped. It has. Interesting. So we do a couple layers of grey on this dry brush. Where's my top quality palette? Probably won't show up on stream particularly well. This is just getting the black to look like a lava rock. This is a Stormcast Eternals StarDrake, which is their sort of their hero monster character for Warhammer Age of Sigmar. Yeah, it looks like you can actually see. The camera's decided to look like it's auto-focusing today. So, one layer of dark grey. And then a slightly lighter grey. RTX voice just seems to not be knocking out this for a change. And I need to follow my guide that I look at. Yep, lighter grey around the edges. I'll do this reasonably quickly so it all blends nicely together. Yeah, it's not got enough angles to be a hell drink. But to give a tease of something else that will be painted at some point soon. Do this on the little camera only. Oh, I nearly put it in my drinking water. Right, and then to do some fake object source lighting around the edge. Nice bright red. I'll move them out just to give a then this just goes on the rock walls. Just to give the effect that the lava that will be going in here is illuminating up the side of the rocks. And then whilst that's dying, let's put some a very quick bit of orange on there as well. Very light amount of orange compared to the red. Right, that brush can soak now. Oh shit, let's change the stream type because it's not really specific enough. There we go, painting the StarDrake. So start putting the lava in now. Where's my Stormcast test model gone? So he's going to have a lava base like this chap. He basically just banned colours from dark red all the way up to white for the lava. I've not done it quite such a large one. The largest one so far has been the Griff Charger, which is about that big model. By far the most involved paint scheme I've done for any of my models, because the base is about 15 steps versus just put some texture paint down, done. No idea why this base is warped as well. I've never had that happen before. Doesn't sit flat. It might straighten. I think what I'll do is put a heavy book on it overnight. Already 5 paints used. So we need to let that dry a bit. So I'm going to go and try and get the Rift Charger out of the box up here, so I can go look at how I did the flesh on the animal whilst the dog just scratches its way in the corner. Nice, this is the biggest Stormcast model I have so far. Right, so this is yellow at the extremes and red on the center of the body by the looks of it. So I just have to scale. Easy. That's a task for another day. Alright, next layer of red. Is there three layers of red or four layers of red in this? Hi. Normally the drying time isn't a problem because I'm doing a batch of models, so by the time I've gone down to the end of five of them, it's already dried. This is all just about ever decreasing slowly smaller. Where the magma is coolest towards the objects, it's darker. Lava base. Instead of the other one. I think I might actually start just putting some base colours in. This wing is my test model. Need to water it down though. So we go red, orange, yellow on this. So yellow roughly there, red, orange roughly there. At least the red's gonna extend to about here. Yeah, the flow is not something that usually bothers me. I often just do it straight out of the pot or onto the pot, onto a pallet, and then onto the model, but something this size, you sort of need to keep it a bit looser. Because in a second, I'm going to start throwing some yellow in there. Yellow, orange. I don't need it wet to blend between the two. Camera colours are really off. That just looks like one awful shade of red. The yellow, because otherwise that will ruin it. And the benefit of having a palette is you can just get the colours on there and actually mush them all together yourself. Whilst the paint is still wet. Actually use the paint that's on the models to blend it in. These tips on the end are going to be yellow, so put a picture on Twitter, you can see that when it's dried. Color correction on this camera is a bit shonky. This will get a wash and a shade as well to get all the detail back. So back on the base train. With yet another red. Almost to the point of being pinky orange. What scheme are you going for? It's all just merging into one on the camera, but there is that light does not help, that just blinds it out. Definitely check out my Twitter account after this. Fulgrim's a very sad book. I think I'll put this orange on and then go have some lunch. Really can just about see that coming in the camera colours. Really to sort the colour correction out of this. Wonder if it's the lighting in here. Made very little difference. You can see this a bit better now. So he's going to go on there. Hello, dog. I think I shall stop there. Let's take the photo for Twitter whilst we're here. I shall post that right now. Right, let's, what should we call this? So if you go to Twitter, it's on my banner things down there. You should see what it actually looks like in real life. Twitter.com/_JohnCrew, something like that. I'll put a link in the chat. But normally my chatbot spams it out, but appears not to have done so today. Thanks for watching. I'll probably be back another lunchtime this week and we'll do a bit more. Get some yellow on that base. And then the base is pretty much done. Once it's had yellow, white and a couple washes on there, then we can start this thing. The wing seems pretty successful. Probably needs another coat on the yellow area because it's a bit patchy. That's a good test. Right, see you all another time.